Hello everyone, welcome to this digital edition of Electric Earth Concerts. My name is Hannah Collins, I'm a cellist and the cello half of the duo New Morse Code together with percussionist Michael Compitello. For our program today, we'll be joined by pianist and composer Thomas Kotcheff. We'd like to thank Laura Gilbert, Jonathan Bagg, and everyone at Electric Earth for inviting us to give the performance in this format as we're not able to travel to New Hampshire at this time. We're very excited to share with you today a program celebrating American innovation and the tradition of the American musical Maverick. We'll be looking back at pieces by Phil Glass and Frederic Rzewski, which experiment with different formats of compositional form and instrumentation. We'll also be looking at some composers that we know, including Pulitzer Prize-winning Bang on a Can co-founder David Lang and Hawaiian composer Tonia Ko. And we'll close the program with a world premiere screening of a new video we've made of Thomas Kotcheff's duo for New Morse Code called Then and Then and Then This. We're going to start with some Philip Glass music called Music in Similar Motion. This piece is for open instrumentation, meaning he doesn't specify exactly which instruments should be played, but he does specify the sort of sequence of patterns that will play through and when different layers will appear in the music. It's a great piece to play with friends, and we are able to present it today despite being in Los Angeles, Kansas City, and Chicago. So we've layered this performance together specifically for you all. Enjoy the show. Thank you.
This is the third movement of Frederic Rzewski's Songs of Insurrection. The complete piece is seven movements, and in each movement, Rzewski takes an international song of protest and uses that as the basis for the piece. For the third movement, he uses the civil rights song, Ain't Gonna Let Nobody Turn Me Around. The original song sounds like this.
Ain't gonna let nobody
Rzewski uses that melody as the basis of the piece, and in the beginning you hear the piano play that melody in a rather slowed down and mournful way, and then the piece kind of unravels from there as a fantasy built on that theme. I'd like to dedicate this performance today to the late John Lewis and to those who continue to fight for democracy everywhere. Thank you.
The next piece on the program is Stuttered Chant by David Lang. David Lang is a composition professor at the Yale School of Music, a Pulitzer Prize winner, and one of the founders of Bang on a Can. He wrote this piece for cellist Maya Beiser and percussionist Evelyn Glennie. And in this piece, the cellist is given a quite complicated piece of music to play, and the percussionist is given a cello and asked to play along. So it's Mike's challenge in this piece to invent a way of playing in unison with me, either by sort of imitating what I look like or imitating what I sound like by drawing out different tones and pitches and carefully treating the cello like it's a drum. So the piece is a lot of fun to play because there's a lot of opportunity for variation from night to night and also from performer to performer. So here is New Morse Code's version of David Lang's Stuttered Chant. Thank you.
next piece on the program is called Negative Magic, and it's by Tonia Ko, who is a composer and visual artist who is a Guggenheim Fellow in 2018 and currently teaches at Royal Holloway University of London. This piece, Negative Magic, is for solo snare drum, and it was written as part of a project I'm doing called Unsnared Drum, where I ask composers to work with me on finding unique and interesting ways of reinventing the snare drum. Tonia wrote a piece for Hannah and I called Hush that is one of the most creative pieces that we've ever played, and when I started this project, I immediately thought of her as someone who would do something really incredible with the snare drum. She describes this piece, Negative Magic, as a exploration of discovering richness and complexity of sound in the instrument by relinquishing control. In the piece, I play a normal snare drum, which is detuned, where I take all of the places you tune the drum and I make them all slightly different and really, really loose. And the piece is a series of sonic adventures exploring this creative new sound world in really intuitive and innovative ways. Throughout the piece, you'll see me explore all of the different kinds of types of sounds I can make with this instrument using a variety of different implements, variety of playing techniques, and a variety of other things that I hope will surprise and delight you. Tonia describes this piece as kind of a ritual between the performer who acts as sort of a magician or a wizard and the drum, this sort of cauldron from which all of these incredible sounds emerge. So hope you enjoy Negative Magic. Hi everyone, we have one final piece for you this evening, and it's called Then and Then and Then This by Thomas Kotcheff. You've seen a lot of Thomas so far in this performance as a performer, and we're really excited to share this video of his duo for Hannah and I with you all. This piece Thomas described as one of the most collaborative pieces he's ever written. We got together for a few weeks at Avalok Farm Music Institute, and each day Thomas would bring Hannah and I a sketch of something that he had worked on that we would kind of try out, and then he would sort of edit and come back to us with another sketch the next day. And then over the course of a few weeks, by taking in our suggestions and sort of experimenting with a wide variety of sounds, techniques, and all sorts of different playing styles, he came up with this piece. The piece is vibrant, it's energetic, it's kind of funny, and it's kind of fun, and it represents both an explosive energy and also sort of a radical impulse to rethink what a cello percussion duo can do. In the piece, Thomas sort of explores a wide variety of things, a wide variety of ways for Hannah and I to play in unison. And what unison means, the definition of that changes throughout the piece. The piece features a wide variety of very unusual percussion instruments, ranging from tuned wooden planks to tuned wine bottles and whiskey bottles, to teeny tiny little wood blocks, to various kitchen implements and junk metal objects, to a wooden salad bowl, and to my personal favorite, the squirrel buster, which is a squirrel hunting tool that Thomas has repurposed as a musical instrument. This video is a world premiere, so you are the first people to see the video of Then and Then and Then This, which we recorded last summer at Oktaven Audio. Before we show you this video, I just wanted to thank everyone at Electric Earth again for giving us the opportunity to share this performance with you. We'd love to hear from you, and please enjoy Thomas Kotcheff's Then and Then and Then This.